Previously on Big Brother, the contestants reached the halfway point after facing a double expulsion. At the end of the day, Anthony became the new H.O.C. and nominated Andrea and Anna for expulsion. Suspicion of Anna holding secret number 3 grew, putting everyone on edge and making the power of veto competition more important than ever. The students faced off in a game of party pong, in which Andrea not only won the veto, but also the luxury prize. She removed herself on the block, and Jesse was nominated for her 4th time. Who will be expelled from the class, and who will become the new H.O.C.? Find out now on Big Brother.
I don't know if I'm gonna regret this. Probably will. Probably I don't know. But I decided. I'm sorry, Jesse. I'm gonna get my replacement on this.
Oh, this is my new favorite chair. All right, and this veto ceremony is adjourned.
A little frustrated right now. A lot frustrated. I got put on the block again. So this is my 4th time sitting in the dang chair. So I'm just kind of frustrated, and I mean, he has to do what's good for his game, but yet I don't think he totally thought this through, because I mean, Anna's gonna take herself off going into Sunday, so then she gets to pick someone to go up, and so I think he thinks that she's gonna put either Felicia or Janae up, which if she doesn't and puts Tasha up, then either me or Tasha's going home. And so, I mean, that pretty much hurts Anthony's alliance. So, I don't know. So, I'm just kind of ticked off. I mean, if he would have put either Felicia or Marjanae, then our team basically would have probably been safe this week.
People up for eviction, expulsion, who trusted me at one point, but everybody did. So, I mean, no matter who I put up, they weren't going to trust me after this. Putting 2 people up who trusted me, and, you know, when you're HOC, you're hoping that, you know, one of them's going to come down maybe, but the other person's still up there, they're going to go. I mean, this is the worst case scenario for anybody in Big Brother ever, where both of them come down and you have to put 2 other people up, and then so these 2 are already coming after you, and then one of these people are gonna stay, one of them's gonna go, so they can't really do anything except be pissed at you and jury, which is already bad, but the other person's gonna come out kind of mistrusting you.
I mean, I felt bad for Jesse, but I mean, it's her, not me. And how many times has she been on it? 4 I felt really bad. She's been on the block 4 times. I was like, I'm sorry, you're done being a pawn. And her time of being a pawn is done. And I felt really bad. And like the target this week, I was like, no.
That's how I feel about Jess being on the fucking block again, honestly. I'm so tired of everyone just using her as a pawn, and people should just vote her off to begin with. Like I said, last interview, she doesn't do anything unless she's on block and she's in the hot seat and she like doesn't talk to anybody. And I think it's at that point now where she is just assuming that everyone's gonna vote to keep her in. And I really don't feel like she's gonna talk to anybody at all this week about it.
I wasn't surprised about Jesse getting put up just because she's been up on the block so many times before. It's an easy person to put up, obviously, since she's already been on the block so many times. But at the same time, Anthony said he made a deal with her that they wouldn't put each other up no matter which one of them won, like HOC. So I didn't think he would put her up just because they made that deal. But Anthony's known to stab people in the back, so still not that surprising.
So So going into next Sunday for expulsion, I'm definitely going to use it on myself and take myself off, which everyone's going to just be so peeved about. But wham, wham on them, because, I mean, they should have found the secret if, you know, they wanted it to be different. So it'll be interesting as to who Anthony's probably going to put on block, but he's probably going to put Natasha up, I feel like. Oh, just kidding. Just kidding. It's been a long day. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so... Oh, that's funny. Okay, I'm not dumb, I swear. So, the fact that I'm going to be taking myself off block and choosing who I get to put on as a replacement, I don't know. It's definitely going to be hard. I would say Marjane or Felicia. I would definitely keep Natasha over Marjane or Felicia. Most likely Marjane, because I'm so fucking tired of her shit talking to everyone. Like, I know it's for shits and giggles, but it gets annoying fast.
Thoughts about going into the expulsion ceremony. I thought I knew what was going to happen. I knew I was going to take yourself off the block. Then you'll probably be replaced with someone. Yeah.
Well, going into Sunday, right now Anna's up, and so I don't know. It really depends on who Anna decides to put on the block, because I mean, I feel like I can be okay if either Felicia or Marjane does get put up, because I think people will target them more than me. I mean, I think Tasha will for sure vote them off, and then since Anna put them up, I would feel like she would vote them, and then the other person. I mean, I feel like Andrea's with Anna, so she would do the same as that. And the only other person who would vote me out would be the other person, either Marjane or Felicia, who wasn't on the block. But if Tasha's on the block, I don't know.
So it's time for another expulsion. Jesse and Anna have been nominated. So if either of you have anything you'd like to say before we go into the vote, Jesse.
Well, I don't have much different to say than the last few times I was up here, but I mean, I feel like I haven't made any enemies with any of you guys, and I'd just like to stay here and maybe get to know each of you a little better, so that's my question.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess same old, I like playing the game, and good competitors, so I guess you guys should keep me.
Right, so before we do the vote, if anyone has the secret power and would like to use it now.
So going into the expulsion, obviously you know that I was hoping Anna would have the power, and then when Jake said that whoever could had the power can stand up and use it if they wanted to, and Anna stood up, I was like, yes! I was so excited because I figured she had it, but I was just obviously not completely sure because you can't tell anyone, and I didn't know what it would be.
Okay, so I guess it's a good idea. Alright, so as most of you probably assumed, I did have a secret. And the secret for this one is the diamond veto. Basically, I can use it up to 3 weeks, or like three, you know, expulsion ceremonies. And I can either take anybody off at any point in the game if I wanted to and put someone else up, or I can take myself off. So, taking myself off, and I put Marjane up on the block.
I'm just kind of thinking about why would she put me up. I mean, I'm not saying put Felicia up. She could have put Tasha up. Whatever, but it's fine.
So yes, Anna did find the diamond power veto. So she's used it to put Marjane. So now Marjane, if you have anything you'd like to say before going into the vote.
I don't like to stay in the game. Yes, I'm not good at this speech stuff.
All right, so we will vote. Everyone will vote except for Anthony and the two nominees. Anthony will only vote in the case of the tie, which there could be tonight because there are four votes. So, Anna, you will come first.
I vote to expel Jesse.
I vote to expel Jesse. Sorry.
I vote to expel Marjane.
I vote to expel Jesse.
So, when I reveal the vote, the expelled student will have just a few minutes to say goodbye. and leave through the classroom door. By a vote of 3-1, Jesse, you've been expelled from the Big Brother game.
Good luck, everyone. Sorry, I smell like Tiger Balm.
It was a 3-1, so it was kind of weird. I was like, what did that weigh? Like, what?
I felt like Marjane would be the better choice to leave, which is why I voted to expel her, just because she's won a competition. She's gotten closer than Jesse has at a lot of competitions, so I felt like it would have been better to get her out now. Plus, she's in an alliance, whereas Jesse, I don't think, is.
Bye. Bye, Marjane. Bye, Jesse.
Bye.
I'm happy that I'm safe. I'm one. When first 3-1, I'm like, who voted to keep me? I'm like, pretty sure Anna doesn't like me. So, and I thought that maybe Andrea voted to get me out.
Surprisingly, all four freshmen have survived. I am so shocked. I am like, I'd be shocked as well. I thought all of us, our asses would be gone by the week four.
I don't know. At the same time, even though I voted for Jess to get out, knowing that Andrea voted Marjane out, I felt like I should have voted to get Marjane out just so it'd be a tie, and then I would see where Anthony would lie as to where, you know, who he'd want to keep in. I didn't really think about it. Honestly, I thought it'd be a unanimous vote, but then I forgot about the whole Andrea and, like, Marjane and Felicia thing, so I kind of bummed myself out for not getting it tied, but oh well.
So you are at the final six at this point, except for head of class, like you'll all be playing in power veto competitions from here on out, so be prepared for that. But before we go to the competition, it's time to reveal a clue to the fifth and final St. Scholastica secret. Yeah. So this one is unique for a few different reasons. First of all, I'm gonna tell you what the secret is called, but I'm not gonna tell you what it does. So Big Brother secret is called the Big Brother vote. That's what it's called. The secret can be used at two different times and in two different ways. It only can be used once, but there's multiple ways it can be used and multiple different times when it can be used in the game. You'll get a total of 3 clues to the secret. One today, one tomorrow after nominations, and one tomorrow after the Power Veto competition. Other than that, you won't be given any other information on, which means I will not tell you when the secret's been found. You will not know when the secret is used. You'll only be told once the secret's been used that it has been used and when it was found, and you will not find out who it was found by. However, this secret is not top secret, which means you can share with other people what it does. You can use it to your advantage. It just means you can tell the truth about whether you have it or you can lie about it. So it's up to you to decide when the secret's been found, when it hasn't. It's gonna be a lot of work because, like I said, the secret could be found tomorrow, but you'll still get clues for the rest of the week. So the only other thing I can tell you is that this secret expires at final four. So when there's 4 people left in the game, it's no good other than that. So your first secret, your first clue to this secret is that it is tied to a tree. And that is all you get so far. So that's the secret. So now what we'll do, can you bring all your stuff. We're going to go to the location of the competition. I have my car parked where the competition is at, so you can put your stuff in my car until we're done with the competition.
Well, he said that you could use it 2 different ways, and since it's like Big Brother vote, I'm guessing you can like maybe stop someone's vote or like count as 2 votes. That's what I'm thinking, which I feel like most people vote together at this point anyways, so I feel like it might not be that big of a deal unless like you're the person on the block and you have it, then it can benefit you, I think, more.
Okay, so finding out that there was another secret, I was super excited. And then when Jake said that, you know, the secret was tied to a tree, my automatic thought was the trails behind the school, even though that's a bit obvious, but also the fact that it was like secret number 4 was underneath the table, which was pretty obvious. So, I don't know. You know, maybe I'm hoping nobody has looked back there if it's, you know, back there, but I'm excited to go look for it, actually.
So, the name of this competition is called Light It Up, and here's how it's gonna work. You're essentially going to step up onto these light poles and hang on for as long as you can. So, you're going to stand on the rim of the concrete bricks like this and hold on. Last person left standing wins. At the 90-minute mark, the competition will get more difficult, and then after that it is here, last person left standing. You may not use iPods or phones or any sorts of entertainment. You may not bring anything up with you. Feet are here. You may not sit on it. You cannot sit anyway.
Oh, so I can't even wrap my legs around it?
No.
Feet
are always on the ground. I mean, you can move one foot at a time.
On the ground?
You can't, like, sit like this. You can't squat. Feet are the only thing that you're using to hold yourself up. Feet, arms to hold on to.
Well, it was really important for, like, one of the final four I have to win, and I knew it would kind of come down to me just because of, like, the physical capabilities of the others. It's a game. Everyone has their strengths.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This challenge is on.
Woo! Yeah! Hello, everyone!
On the concrete part too, no climbing up onto the pole.
Can I walk around the concrete?
Yes.
I can, like, turn in a circle?
Yes.
So this H.O.C. is pretty crucial. Like, Andrea and I already know that, you know, everyone's on our ass to get us out. So I was like, well, I already knew going in, I was like, I'm not leaving this damn pole until I win. So I already had it in my mind so that I was gonna win it.
I'm not gonna listen to you, Anthony. I'm gonna fall.
Inside. You wanna get off.
Okay. Oh, I'll face this way so I can wave at random people and they'll think I'm
creepy. How did it last that? I would be surprised if it lasts that long, but...
My feet hurt!
I was debating, I was like, do I keep my shoes on? Do I not keep my shoes on? And then getting on top of the pole, with my shoes, it was actually quite painful just because, like, you know, your shoes can't form to the curvature of the pole. So that was, you know, that was actually quite painful. And then I think after like 3 minutes, I was, you know, I just said fuck it and took off my shoes. And that was actually so much easier. I'm actually really happy I decided to do that.
It's like you can't get your feet on here, honestly.
So the competition worked as you had to stand on this light pole. And you had to put your feet on this concrete thing that has like probably less than an inch worth of space to put your feet on. And it's circular, so it hurts more. And then you had to hold on, and you just had to stand there until you couldn't hold on anymore.
It hurts.
Cheating?
No? Are you cheating?
I wish.
I'm just gonna walk around this thing a couple times.
How do you feel about this competition?
I feel rough. My foot size is size 11, so I get like less room than everyone else.
This is so unfair. Because I wear size 11 shoes in female, and fucking Anna wears size 5.5 in children, maybe, whatever. Whatever, she wears size 5.5, and I'm like, this is not fair. This challenge was not meant for me, because I am this, like, lanky, like, unnormal, like, Asian. I wish I had my mom's size feet. Like, she has size 7, and I'm just like, where the heck did I come from?
This thing vibrates. You should come listen to it.
Probably can't.
I don't like it.
She was gonna be helpful, but hopefully it doesn't last 3 hours.
You feel more comfortable like moving back rather than keeping closer?
Honestly, it sucks. It's like, you don't have enough space to put your feet on here, and so like, your ankle like, moves out, so you can have like a good footing, and it hurts like hell right now. Hey, it's not that bad. I can move around this thing, and then, oh my God, it starts to hurt. Like, my ankle starts to hurt right away. I'm like, oh, this is bullshit. Oh my God, I don't know. She's a bitch for doing that. And I don't know who if I don't still I know I can't trust her no matter what. I'm sorry. I know I can't trust her no matter what. And so she's still like my number one target, definitely.
So the competition, we had to stand on the light poles and we had to stand on the cement part around the bottom. And at that point, I was like, oh, this is no problem, whatever.
So I got on and like I figured out like which way like worked best for me. I put my feet like both going this direction around it rather than standing like this because it didn't hurt my knees. And then that way I could turn when that side of my foot hurt to this side. So like my feet never really hurt very bad, which was good.
Going on.
This is a lot easier.
Really?
I switched it up. I was like, huh, this other one like bends my knees out. All day.
Yeah, I feel like because you're gonna be here till like 5 minutes.
Yeah, I don't know what these things are gonna be. They're gonna throw us off though.
Oh yeah.
Like, after
it's gonna be like you gotta get off that. We had a little conversation. It was kind of nice that everybody was far enough away from each other on these light posts that I could actually just get, you know, some kind of quiet one-on-one conversations with people. I thought she was going to be a lot more pissed than she was, and I just kind of wanted to smooth things over. I mean, mostly for the game, obviously, but also just, I don't know, she seemed really pissed, obviously, with what she's been, just how she's been acting, her reaction to after when she won the veto and everything. Yeah, I was a little afraid for if she won HOC, what she would do.
Assumedly, you're in her tone. So.
Oh my God,
I've already come to the fight for this week.
Well, to be honest with you, I thought about it, and if I went, I'm probably going to
your mom's faster than your body.
Because it's not the best for me. I think that if Felicia, either Felicia or Marjanik don't go home, then one of them's going to win. So I don't want that to happen. So that's probably what I'd put
them.
Okay.
And well, either
if,
way,
but if one of them won, we,
yeah,
well,
obviously.
Then,
yeah. I mean, that's like that's what I was thinking too.
Next.
It's like it wouldn't matter either way, because at that point it would be. I mean, they're going to
so
go for each other, obviously.
You'd still want to win, you know, obviously,
okay,
over them, because,
She said, yes, she's pissed, but she'd stick to, you know, she doesn't feel like she can beat Marjanae and Felicia in this game, so she would still want to see one of them gone before she wants to see me gone. Okay. that sounds good to me.
Honestly, I thought it was going to come to so I was pretty, I had a speech prepared, but
I thought it was gonna as well, but then I thought about it and I'm like, why would anyone else want to keep Marjanae and Felicia? So I think maybe Marjanae will go out, and then I was like, no.
Wait, so did you just like go with that and you're like, whatever, let's just go to Jesse?
No, I voted on Marjanae. That was
okay, that's what I thought.
Like, just because obviously I feel like, yeah, I wanted one of them out. And I figured Anna would vote her out since she put her on the block.
I kind of thought that too, but I know that Anna was saying that she's not a fan, like Jesse's like just kind of going through the game without coming in.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not either, but I just feel like she'd be easy to get out of.
Yeah, or like we have zero votes in her.
Yeah.
Or as far as too.
Yeah, I don't know. I probably wouldn't have taken her with me if I don't do that.
The 45 minute mark right now. Again, 45 minutes.
So much better with my shoes. It was like making it really hard to get my foot on here, and I was hurting my ankles because they had to be like out so much. So it hurt really bad, and I was like, oh my god, like 5 minutes left for me. But now this is so much better.
She wouldn't want to go after you still, which is good. She still that she would try to get up to you. But she's just, that's just what she's saying. It's a chance.
Did Anna want
you
to go away?
She did it right away. She's like, oh, I don't want to talk to her. You're distracting me, blah, blah, blah. But
yeah,
then I talked to her later.
Like,
I didn't really like say much, but yeah.
Yeah.
Me too.
I don't know, I might be the first. Like, my ankles are going to give out.
Really?
My ankles are really bad.
Marjanae is about to fall. She told me. I'm going to go run for like half an hour, see if I can find anything. And then I'll come back by the hour and a half mark. But any in there?
Maybe I'll be out there.
Well, unfortunately.
You're lucky you get to sit out this one.
I guess.
Where are you gonna look? Just gonna look.
Just gonna go run through a bunch of trees. I'm probably not even in an area I look, I'm probably not gonna be able to find or look through everything, but for now I'm just gonna go run through the trail. I'm gonna go do that. But, alright, see ya.
My ankles hurt in places they shouldn't hurt. The pain, like, my fingers were, everything was warm. Like, I was not cold. The pain was in my ankles, because they're, like, at, like, a weird, like, angle. Like, ugh. Just weird. I'm probably not going to win this anyway from, like, just the bad condition I'm doing right now. So, yeah. Step down.
All right. All right, Marjane has stepped off at the 50-minute mark. Marjane is out of the competition.
My reason to step down is because, one, I know I'm not going to make it to 90 minutes, and hurting myself even more is just ridiculous. So I'm like, I probably won't win this competition, and I mean, I can go search for the secret. And I had homework.
So you couldn't push through anymore? Like, I was like, oh great, like all of this is on me and Tosh. And I was like, it's already hard enough on me. Stupid feet. Fucking excited. 11 feet.
Oh, I kept trash talking Marjane. I was like, Marjane, I'm going to trash talk you until you get down. And she was the first one to get down, so I thought that was pretty funny. Wasn't honestly expecting her to last that long, which she didn't, so that was no surprise there.
Marjane stepped down. I was obviously really happy because I'm one person closer to winning the HOC, but I was surprised because I didn't think it was very hard to stand on the cement. So, but it was good for me, so.
Super excited, one person down. Woohoo! One person closer to winning. I'm good. It's nice because I can just like flip around, you know, like this. And then like only half of my foot hurts, so like when I switch, like this half doesn't hurt. And then like the other side like has time to recover, so then I switch and that side doesn't hurt anymore.
There you go.
Good. I'm doing well. I'm hungry. I wish I had a snack. I didn't eat since noon. If I have to pee, if I will get in trouble for public indecency, because I think I could probably pull my pants down without falling off.
No one fucking leaves. They all stare at me like I'm a fucking zoo animal.
You know what those guys said that to like,
yeah, they're so nice to me.
What'd they say?
I was like, hi, and they're like, hey, and I was like, have a good night. And they're like, you too. Oh. That's so nice. And they were really hot. I'm literally gonna bitch everyone off that does not wait.
I can start taking down license plate numbers.
Please do. I'll drive back to their hometown. Show up at their parents' doorsteps. Oh god. Like your son or daughter is it's gonna happen.
Yeah, okay, so we couldn't have any entertainment at all, like on us. We couldn't have cell phones, iPods, you know, like music, social media. So I was actually in the dead center pole. In the front of the parking lot, facing the dorms, and I was like, well, there's a lot of traffic, I might as well just start waving to people. And I'm not gonna lie, I was a little mean to the people. I said some profound language to those who didn't wave back at me or say hi. But yeah, even the people that were just walking about, you know, I made conversation with them. A lot of people, I mean, for as many people that didn't wave or say hi back, you know, I probably creeped them out. That's totally okay with me. I don't mind that. But for the ones that did say hi and, like, actually made a conversation and, like, there was actual cars that stopped and rolled down their windows to see what I was doing, it was actually a lot of fun. It made the competition, you know, a lot more enjoyable. And it made me put myself out there, like, just so I could be entertained. So that was a lot of fun.
I told you about my natural birth.
You have
no. Okay, you know girls have their like wedding planned.
Sure.
I have my birthing experience. So I went at home with all the women in my family and my husband, and then to have it in the kitchen with a water birth. I'm just natural. I know it's crazy, but that's how I want it at home. If it's okay, because I don't want to have it in the hospital. Like you know how they always do it in films, where the woman's like laying on her back, like spread eagle, basically, and the baby pops out. That's not natural. I'm not excited for that. But yeah, that's my plan. My life. Thanks.
Hopefully my boyfriend doesn't watch this, or my future husband. I have everything planned.
Yeah. No, I'm not pregnant! No, I'm just telling you about my ideal birthing experience. Because I don't have my wedding planned, but I have my natural birthing experience planned. I'm not pregnant. I'm not pregnant! I promise!
You're pregnant?
No! Jake, you have to keep this in! Whatever I'm talking about is beautiful!
My feet are fine, but my ankles hurt. No me gusta. No bueno. Española. I'm not in Spanish, and I know it's not Española. I'm not ignorant.
As we approach the 90-minute mark, I'm guessing that we're gonna have to move up on the pole. Either to like the bottom rings or like the upper one that was like kind of like up to like maybe here on me or something.
90-minute mark. So what you're gonna be doing is moving up onto the black part of the lamppost. That is where you must stay for the rest of the competition. You can't go up to that higher level. No, not the highest one, Andrea. Just right above the concrete.
Higher?
Yep. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, no, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, this is where you are.
But I knew that we'd be getting, you know, it was kind of obvious that we'd be moving up onto the pole. So I wasn't too worried about that. I was just worried about how I was going to be able to stay on it.
Alright, so when 90 minutes came, we had to go up to the bottom rings, not the, like the top ones, so the very bottom ones, which were, obviously it would have been like a lot harder to stand on those ones than the top one, just because the top one was flat, and these bottom ones were like slanted, and it was like once I got up on it, I was like, oh, this is going to be really hard, people are going to drop fast after this.
I'm slipping. It's not like flat.
It was really hard to get a footing, and I found that taking your shoes off helped for the cement portion. 90 minutes later, we're supposed to like go on this curvy part, like I don't know, like the curvature of like the part that makes the light post pretty, because I'm pretty sure that's like the decorative part of it. And it was just like, oh, okay, you got 10 seconds left. So I'm trying to put like my shoes back on and like tighten them. Do you not see that move? The shit's moving. You gave me one that moves. You didn't check if these are all okay.
Felicia is out of the competition. Tell me what happened.
I didn't get good grips at all. I mean, it was hard already with these shoes. My shoes were off too. It was really hard with the grip. Oh, because I mean, if I was here, I would probably do better. Because that one's smaller. I don't know why you look, but that, I mean, this is harder because it's all slippery. I'm impressed with myself. I could have gone a little longer, I wish.
I was like, shit, only Tosh has to, like, we have to depend on Natosh because Marjane got out, like, at 50 minutes, 55, 50, somewhere around there. And then Tosh, she's, like, the only soul left that can play, and I was like, I felt so bad because I was like, I knew I could last longer, or at least try to. And what sucks is Tosh's ankle, she has a bad ankle, and I was like, this game is all about, like, ankles and stuff, and I was like, I feel so bad, but she's pushing herself. I was like, those two better hurry up, like Anna and Andrea like fall off. And
I already knew it was gonna be me, Natasha, and Andrea left. So I had already predicted that was gonna happen, and when it happened, I wasn't, you know, too worried about it.
Once Felicia dropped, I was glad because the people I wanted to drop the most were Marjane and Felicia, just because I felt like they would put me up. And then Natasha and Anna, like, I feel the best with them out of the other people. So I just figured that if I did need to drop, I'd be in a better place if Felicia and Marjane were down. So
this was a lot harder. Especially for my big feet.
Exactly, right?
So when we got onto the slanted base at the 90-minute mark, you know, he gave us like 10 seconds to, you know, get prepared for it. And being in my socks and trying to like maneuver onto the actual metal instead of the concrete, I kept slipping and I was like, oh god, I'm screwed. So I had yelled to Jake as he was coming out. I was like, wait, give me time. Because I knew that I would have to take off my socks in, you know, 48 degree weather on a metal pole. But I knew I'd have a lot more grip than anyone else. So I was like, you know, fuck it. I'm going to do whatever it takes to win this challenge. So I ended up taking off my socks and being barefoot for the rest of the competition.
But let's be honest. If I win this with no socks,
people are just gonna look like this. They're sad.
No, but for real, I didn't have any other strategy because I have no grip on my socks. So I threw them off. And now I'm barefoot.
Let's bring the ship into the shore. Da 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 da. Baby, I can't fight this feeling anymore. And it's the cold. Also, I do love my boyfriend, but that's not the feeling. Ugh, there's hair in my mouth!
Well, at first, we just had to, like, chill out on a pole, but we could have our feet on the edges. And then after an hour and a half, we had to move up, so, like, our ankles were kind of more angled, which it was harder to grip, and my ankle started to hurt more. It was just harder to stay on, because I felt like if I was leaning in closer, I would slip. So I tried to stay out, which hurt my back and arms.
I wish I knew how the other one. I wonder how long Anna can stand without her socks on.
She's probably a lot shorter than you can. I love her, so that would feel...
I think she might win. I'm trying my best.
You got this.
Well, that's a fucking powerhouse.
What?
Huh?
What'd you say?
I said two against one, and one was a fucking powerhouse.
Ugh. Natasha, how you doing? You can quit.
Why?
I won't put you off.
I just want them to fucking quit. I so I can just stay out one barefooted. Plus, I'm not shaking.
So I used like my $10.
So, pretty good. I'm past the point of not feeling my feet though. So I might have to go to the ER after this. Just to make
just
sure.
Just let you know, it goes to numb, then it gets to stingy.
Yeah, I know. No, I can't feel my feet at all.
Exposed skin for like 2.5 hours touching metal is probably not the smartest idea. I mean, I have not studied anything about it yet, but I know, like instinctual, like you know when something's not right. You're supposed to be covered in the winter, and it was like, you're cold.
Can only move my big one. Barely.
We're gonna have to take her to the emergency room.
So yeah, I'm gonna drive to the office because this is sucking.
So after like 10 minutes past the 90 minute mark of being barefoot, my feet went completely numb. And the wind, when I started, you know, barefoot, the wind really hurt my feet just because it was so cold. And then like after 10 minutes, my feet were completely numb. Couldn't move my toes at all. Couldn't move my feet. But I wasn't shaking. It wasn't cold to where my body was shaking. Not even my legs were shaking. My feet were just solid to the pole and I was completely fine. I wasn't, you know, freaking out. Nothing was hurting. My feet weren't hurting. Ankles, knees, back, hands, arms, they weren't hurting at all. So I was just fine.
I think I can outlast Anna, but I'm gonna try. And I think I can outlast Andrew if she's shaking.
You don't have that mentality. You can beat them. You can beat them.
I'll be your cheerleader.
Where's the papa?
Yes, he is.
go.
All right, Anna, Andrea, and Natasha, you are at the 2 hour mark. 120 minutes, it is 10, 22, and 47 degrees out, so keep it up.
Yeah, so Andrea, she was squatting. She was basically like kind of doing squats when we got up to the 90 minute mark and we had to change position. And then I see that one of her shoes are off. I don't know why she decided to take off one shoe and then not even try and get her sock off.
And I think I'm probably gonna fall pretty. I took my shoe off because I thought it'd be easier and it's harder.
I was the only one with shoes on at this point. I heard that Natasha had socks on and Anna was barefoot. I could see that from where I was. And I felt like that might have been giving them a better grip just because just the curvature of your foot, like it's more obviously easy to like bend around like the pole and stuff, I was thinking. And so I'm like, maybe I should take my shoes off. So I take one shoe off and I immediately regretted it.
So how are you feeling at the 2 hour mark?
Awful. Anna, if I fall, is that a bad thing?
No, dude, you're safe. I swear to God.
Natasha, if I fall, are you gonna put me up?
After I took that shoe on, I was hanging on with one foot, like 100%. Like, I had no grip at all on that other foot. It was just sliding around. I was turning around on the pole without even trying. Like, it just became really difficult at that point, and I knew I was in trouble. Jake, this is bad.
What you want?
So I knew from there that she wasn't gonna last long and that it was gonna be me and Natasha left, but considering how close we are in this game right now, she knew that she wasn't, you know, in fear for her life of, you know, me putting her up on block 5-1. She was just nervous of Natasha possibly putting her up.
This is the worst.
You're safe with me, Andrea.
I'm just nervous that she's gonna get it, and I don't know if she's being truthful.
Well, we all play veto, so I mean...
You look a lot better than she does.
My butt was hurting, and my inner thighs were hurting just from like bending my legs and like hunching over, and like my arms kind of hurt just from like when I try to like, I would try to like grab onto like the round part, the upper part, and like push myself up a little bit, so that would hurt my arms too. So pretty much everything was hurting.
I can't make it. I'm dying.
You would take off your socks.
I can't. If I lift up my foot. All right, so I took off my shoe. Worst decision, should have kept it on. I'm gonna fall. I'm sorry to all my viewers and fans. I'm going down.
All right, Andrea is out of the competition. Andrea stepped down at 2 hours and 7 minutes.
I got off the pole because at that point, I looked around, I see Anna, she's not struggling whatsoever. And I knew I was gonna fall anyways, so I figured I might as well just jump off so I don't get hurt because I couldn't hang on any longer. Like, I was gonna slip off anyways. Like, I was getting there, and I just was like, well, if I know I'm gonna fall, I might as well just do it the safe way.
Okay, so it's 2 hours and we're almost done. We have two people left. Andrea falls off. I'm like, yes, come on, Tosh, you got this. But Anna is fucking stubborn. We all know Anna's stubborn.
Almost 2.5 hours.
Well, at 9:50.
It's almost 10:52, so it's almost 2.5 hours.
So it's almost been an hour.
Between Anna and Tasha, I'm just like, Anna, just fall, your feet are not. I'm like, does it really?
Does winning this really matter to your feet? Like, is that more important than having frostbite? Like, I don't know. All I'm saying. And then she's like, I don't know.
And I honestly don't think that she would be. Just because she just put
me. Ever?
Okay, so Natasha was kept asking if she would be safe, and Anna kept telling her, yeah, you're fine, you're good, like, you're not my target, but Natasha was obviously hesitant about it, and I told Natasha it was probably a good thing to be a little hesitant, because, I mean, I'm not going to tell her to drop and then have something happen and be like, oh, well, you told me I'd be safe, so I wasn't going to tell her to drop, but I told her I thought she would be okay if she did, but I told her I wasn't going to tell her to drop. Specifically.
Well, first, Andrea had asked me if she would be safe, so I was like, okay, maybe I should do that as well, because I knew I wasn't going to stay on much longer. So Anna was doing her own, like, cocky thing and shouting back and forth, so I just shouted over there and asked her if I would be safe, like, no front door, back door, because if one of her targets comes down, I want to make sure I'm not going up next. And she said I would be safe, but I don't know, there was some hesitation.
I kept telling Tosh, I was like, Tosh, how you doing? And she's like, I hurt, you know, she's in pain, you know, blah, 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 whatever. And I was like, no, I'm not gonna put you up, like, just let me win this, because, like, look at it this way, like, I'm barefoot, in the freezing cold, possibly have frostbite, all for goddamn competition. Like, I was dedicated to winning.
Well, it's hard having bigger feet.
Yeah. Did you say that you wear size 9?
You have big feet, too.
Yeah. I think that's why she's doing so good, is because her feet are so small.
Okay. Yep. What's happening?
Oh. All right, Natasha's out, which means Anna, you're the winner of the head of class.
And I just screamed. I just screamed and wailed of, like, happiness. I was like, oh my god, yes. Like, I couldn't stop screaming. I was so happy, you know, that I had finally won after, you know, 2.5 hours. I was relieved and I was happy. And, I was so overjoyed.
So then, Natasha falls. I'm kind of glad, just because I have this thought in the back of my head, she might be working with Felicia and Marjane and Anthony. So, but at the same time, I think maybe she just is kind of trying to go with, like, majority of the house and what they want. I don't know if she'd actually put me up, but I feel like I trust Anna a lot more than I trusted her. So I was glad when Anna was the one that won. And then when Anna got down, I immediately wanted to go over and see how she was walking, just because she said her feet were numb and then they got warm and she thought her feet were going to fall off. So.
Holy cow, the bottoms are heavy.
Put your socks on!
Yeah, put the socks on, like, now.
Put your socks on! Come on!
I can't!
Put your socks on!
This hurts!
You have to do it! You have to!
Nurse Andrea to my rescue! Ow! Oh my god! This is hell! Ow! I can't!
Does that hurt?
This fucking is so hurt so much. Oh, ow, fucking Christ. I'm not putting on my shoes. I can't. Oh my god.
Oh yeah. And I kicked him in the face.
How are you feeling?
Like, why is it my responsibility to just win for everyone else? Like, I don't know, I did my best. And Anthony sent me a really nice text, like, proud of you, I wouldn't have lasted 2.5 hours. I'm like, yeah, I don't know how I did. It was really painful. But, like, I did the best I could, and people were telling me, like, no, you can do it, you can outlast her, but I don't think there's any way that was gonna happen.
Oh, fuck, she won. I was like, Andrea was so happy and stuff, you could see it, and I was like, I didn't want Anna to win. And I was like, Marjane and I were probably on the block, we, like, gave each other this look, and we're like, oh. And we're like, we're done.
I'm just like, everyone's like, oh, Anna, you're toes. I'm just like, oh, I don't give a fuck. Like, she should have kept her socks on. Like, oh my god, I'm so angry with her. Definitely Anna winning, because I know, I'm pretty sure that me or Felicia are, like, one of her targets. Probably Anthony, because he put her up, but
fucking sucks.
Anna, after I think it was like 2 hours and 34 minutes or something like that, Anna's the new head of class. She'll have until we're going to meet at 8:30 p.m. tomorrow for the nomination ceremony. So, she'll be expulsion. Have a good night. Take care of your feet.
Yeah, I'll come back with no feet tomorrow.
All right.
Going into nominations, I mean, talking last week, I had already had a plan of what I was going to do if I'd won, and I'm probably going to stick with that plan of putting Felicia Marginet up, I feel like, is what I'm going to do. Just because I told Natasha yesterday I wasn't going to put her up. Obviously not going to put Andrea up. Who else is left? Yeah, and Anthony. I really don't feel like, I mean, I know Anthony has it out for me, but I just really want to see how it's going to go with Felicia and Marginet up against each other.
It's kind of a bummer because I can't really talk to Anna before. I mean, we talked a little bit out there, but mostly, so I just like asked what she was kind of thinking of doing, and she said she wants to put up Felicia and Marginet, so I just hope she sticks with that, because I don't, like, I feel like I'm safe with her. Like, I wouldn't put her up, and I feel like it'd be dumb for her to put me up since I, like, she's literally, like, probably the only person I completely trust at this point. So I'm hoping that's what she does and sticks to. And that'd be a good thing for me, just because Felicia and Marginet are working together, obviously, and to split that up, and that'd be really good.
I would like to see me not go up, or Phil. I would like to see Anna put up, like, Andrea or somebody, and then Andrea and I wouldn't be the one. But I don't know. I don't feel as though she's going to put Andrea up, and that's the bad part.
I don't know if you know this, but when Anna, like, is HOC and you want to talk to her, like, we'll call it the Lindsay, because basically she ignored Lindsay, and that's how I felt. And I'm like, okay, if I message her, because I messaged her, like, I saw her at lunch, and I was like, okay, I'll message her later and be like, to talk, because she had to go to class and do stuff. And I was like, okay, whatever, I'll talk to you later. And she's been ignoring me. She ignored me until dinner.
I feel like it's going to be Felicia and Marginet. And one of them comes down, and Anthony's probably going on.
So since I won HOC yesterday, this is the first people to go up on block this week. I will pick the first person, and then we will do two more, and then we will see where it goes from there. So, first person I choose to stay this week is Natasha.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Andrea.
Thank you, Anna. And the final person that is safe this week is Anthony.
Alright. So, Felicia and Marginet, you guys are put on block this week. Just want you to know that it's not my finalized plan yet, and we can definitely talk about it later. But I just want you to know it's nothing personal against you two at all. This is just how it's gotta be for the first couple of days, and see where it goes from there. So, since we're all playing in veto tomorrow, there's no ping pong balls to pick, so this meeting is adjourned.
Second clue to the fifth Saint Scholastica secret is that it's in a place of silence. So, I'll let you figure that out. So, are you free to go?
It's not that I have any hard feelings against them, it's just because that they're like a dynamic duo, that they need to be kind of split up. So hopefully this happens, and I mean, if someone wants a veto that's not them, you know, one of them's going to get taken down, obviously. But I don't know how it's going to go. I'm just pushing for Andrea and I to win the power of veto, honestly, so they won't get it.
It was perfect. Like, the final four playing with Tosh, Anthony, Marginet, and I have, like, gone pretty well. And I mean, at this rate, I'm willing to, like, throw, like... Anthony and Tosh under the bus, which is so bad. Like, I don't want to do it. It feels so, like, horrible. But if I have to, I gotta say Marginet and I.
Anna puts me and Felicia up on the block. I hate her. She doesn't like us. No, I think it's because me and Felicia are, like, close. And she wants to, like, I guess break that. But she's stupid.
Who will win the power of veto? And will it be used to save either Marjane or Felicia from the block? And how will the final secret of Scholastica affect the game? Find out next time on Big Brother, Secrets of Scholastica.